Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jumpa lagi di channel Ahmad Juanda, guru pembelajar. Kali ini kita akan mempelajari teks fungsional report lisan dan tulis. Materi ini adalah materi bahasa dan sastra Inggris kelas 10 semester 2. Well students, adapun tujuan pembelajaran mengidentifikasi dan memahami fungsi sosial, struktur teks dan unsur kebahasaan teks report. 2. Mengidentifikasi bagian-bagian struktur teks report. 3. Memahami struktur teks report terkait meminta dan memberi informasi tentang teknologi. Dan yang keempat, memahami unsur kebahasaan teks report. Okay students, a report text is a type of text that announces the result of an investigation or announce something. The information given in a report text is very general information. Jadi report text adalah jenis teks yang mengumumkan hasil penyelidikan atau mengumumkan sesuatu. Informasi yang diberikan dalam teks laporan adalah informasi yang sangat umum. Social function of report text is to present information about something generally to the reader. Jadi social function dari report text adalah untuk menyajikan informasi tentang sesuatu secara umum kepada pembaca. Secara umum, report text menggambarkan hal-hal yang berkenaan dengan fenomena alam, buatan manusia, dan sosial di lingkungan kita, seperti mamalia, planet-planet, batu, tanaman, negara-negara dan kota, budaya, transportasi, dan sebagainya. Dan report text bersifat ilmiah karena menyajikan fakta-fakta sebagai hasil penelitian atau observasi. Generic structure. The generic structure of report text yang pertama adalah general classification. Berisi pernyataan umum tentang subjek yang dibicarakan atau yang dibahas. Kemudian description merupakan bagian yang memberikan gambaran secara detail mengenai subjek yang dibahas pada bagian general classification. Okay, the example of report text. Contoh dari report text. Pertama, general classification. Venice is a city in northern Italy. It is the capital of region Veneto. Together with Padua, the city is included in the Padua-Venice metropolitan area. Venice has been known as the queen of the Adriatic, city of water, city of bridges, and the city of light. The city stretches across 117 small islands in the Marsi Venetian Lagoon along the Adriatic Sea in northeast Italy. Description. Venice is world famous for its canals. It is built on an archipelago of 117 of islands formed by about 150 canals in a shallow lagoon. The islands on which the city is built are connected by about 400 bridges. In the old center, the canals serve the function of roads, and every form of transport is on water or on foot. You can ride gondola there. It is the classical Venetian boat, which nowadays is mostly used for tourists, or for weddings, funerals, or other ceremonies. Now most Venetians travel by motorized water buses, or called vaporetti, which ply regular routes along the major canals and between the city's islands. The city also has many private boats. The only gondolas still in common use by Venetians are the traghetti, foot passenger ferries crossing the Grand Canal at the certain points without bridges. You can see the amusing city's landmarks such as Piazza San Marco, Palazzo Contarini, the Bufalo, Saint Mark's Cathedral, or Villas of the Veneto. The Villas of the Veneto, rural residences for nobles during the Republic, are one of the most interesting aspects of Venetian countryside. They are surrounded by elegant gardens, suitable for fashionable parties or high society. The city is also well known for its beautiful and romantic view, especially at night. Jadi itulah tadi contoh report text. Report text is a kind of text which present information about something as it is or describes the way things are in general. It is a result of systematic observation and analysis. The characteristics or language features of report text. Karakteristik atau unsur kebahasaan dari text report. Yang pertama, use a general nouns, example smartphone, rather than particular nouns, example my smartphone, general nouns. Maksudnya adalah suatu benda baik itu hidup atau mati yang bersifat umum. Coba bandingkan smartphone dengan my smartphone. Smartphone bersifat umum, sedangkan my smartphone bersifat khusus. Kemudian yang kedua, use a relating verbs to describe features. For example, relating verbs dalam grammar disebut juga dengan linking verbs seperti to be, is, am, are dalam bentuk present. Seem, look, taste, dan lain sebagainya yang digunakan untuk menggambarkan fitur sebuah objek. For example, basically, robot is a machine, it looks high-tech. Kemudian yang berikutnya, some use of action verbs when describing behavior. Action verb ini merupakan kata kerja aktif, di mana kata kerja tersebut menyatakan bahwa suatu subjek sedang melakukan suatu kegiatan yang nyata, yaitu yang dapat dilihat oleh mata dan didengar oleh telinga. Action verbs tersebut dapat diubah dan disesuaikan dengan tense yang kita gunakan. Contoh, people started using smartphone in 1995. Orang-orang mulai menggunakan telepon pintar pada tahun 1995. Yang berikutnya, use of timeless present tense to indicate usefulness. For example, people often access the internet with a web browser. Timeless present tense adalah salah satu penanda waktu dalam simple present seperti often, usually, always, dan lain-lain. Berikutnya, use of technical terms. For example, smartphone. Related to application, email, social media, internet terms, etc. Technical terms maksudnya adalah istilah-istilah yang meliputi text report tersebut, misalnya tentang telepon pintar. Maka istilah-istilah seperti application, game, video, play store, web browser, social media harus ada. Contoh dari report text yang berkaitan dengan teknologi, judulnya adalah tablet. Tablet computer or tablet PC is a mobile computing device designed to be held in one or two hands. It is approximately the size of a hardcover book, 7 inches or bigger, and resembles a large smartphone. Tablets let you do many of the same things as a traditional computer. They can browse the internet, connect to social network applications, and display HD videos. They excel at applications which do not require a large amount of precise user input. Early tablet devices used light pens or a stylus as their input device. However, today all tablets use a touch screen as their primary input device, with the option to connect external devices such as a keyboard. Most tablets only have a few physical buttons, the back, power, and volume buttons, and everything else can be done using your fingers. Today, the top two operating systems used with tablet is Apple iOS, used with iPads, and Google Android, used with Android tablets. A tablet can have application installed onto them to perform a function. The concept of a tablet was first sketched by Alan Kay while at Xerox in 1971. Since then, there have been many iterations of tablet devices, including PDAs, predecessor to the tablet. Ya, itu tadi contoh dari text report yang berkaitan dengan teknologi. Jadi generic structure report text yang pertama adalah general classification. The definition of tablet. A tablet tablet computer or tablet PC is a mobile computing device designed to be held in one or two hands. It is approximately the size of a hardcover book, 7 inches or bigger, and resembles a large smartphone. Descriptions. The detailed elaboration about the functions of tablet. Tablets let you do many of the same things as traditional computer. They can browse the internet, connect to the social network application, and display HD videos. They excel at applications which do not require a large amount of precise user input. The parts of the tablet. Every tablet device is used like pens or a stylus as their input device. However, today all tablets use a touch screen as their primary input device with the option to connect external devices such as a keyboard. Most tablets only have a few physical buttons, the back, power, and volume buttons, and everything else can be done using your fingers. The operating system of tablet. Today, the top two operating systems used with tablets is Apple iOS, used with iPads, and Google Android, used with Android tablets. A tablet can have applications installed onto them to perform a function. The history of tablet laptop was invented by. The concept of a tablet was first sketched by Alan Kay while at Xerox in 1971. Since then, there have been many iterations of tablet devices, including PDAs, predecessor to the tablet. Okay, students, itulah beberapa penjelasan dan contoh teks report. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.